Hello, welcome to the Smart Board. In this example, we're going to talk about the fusion of a component from one layer to the other. So, the fusion crossing the interface. Let me make a sketch. Here are two layers of liquid, both of same thickness, delta. Bottom layer I'll call B, the top layer I'll call A. In both of them, a component X is dissolved. And initially, so at the start of our exercise, the concentration of X in A equals twice the concentration in B, and that is 2 kilograms. Cubic meter. We do have that in equilibrium, the species X is distributed such that the ratio in equilibrium between concentration of X in A over that in B is m equaling 30. And what I would like to know, or the question, let me write that in a different color. 1, is X going from A to B or from B to A? And 2, if I wait long enough, what will the concentrations in both layers be? Like to find that out, these two questions. And we're going to solve that by analyzing this system in the following way. Okay, back to white. First question I would like to address is transport in that direction or in that direction. For that, I need to inspect what the driving force is. And I could state as a first idea, which I call the naive idea, that the driving force, delta C, is by definition the concentration in A minus the concentration in B, which in this case would be 2 minus 1 is 1 kilogram per cube, which is positive, meaning that the driving force is giving from high to lower, and thus we would have this direction from A to B. But I didn't call it naive for fun. I called it naive because it's naive. Actually, 2, not so naive, is realizing that this is transport across an interface and that the equilibrium distribution comes into play, the M. Thus, the actual delta C should not be defined as the difference between the concentration, but should be defined with taking that M into consideration. As now in equilibrium, this driving force is zero, whereas in equilibrium, this driving force is far from zero. And this is 2 minus 30 times 1 is minus 28 kilogram per cube, which is smaller than zero. Thus, I should conclude that the true driving force is from B to E, so the transport is from B to A. Okay, this one done. Next, I need to see what then eventually the concentrations are. How can we get a good handle on this? We can try and guess them, but we can do this in a systematic way. In a systematic way means thinking balances. Which balance would I have in mind? Well, this is clearly the fusion of mass. So let me make a little bit more space. We need a mass balance for component X. And thus, the ddt equals in minus out plus production should be evaluated. But I can do only so for mass of x if we decide for a control volume. And a handy control volume in this case is the entire system. Why? Well, there is no production of x in this system, so this is a zero. If I take the total system, I know that the transport is in that direction, but for this balance, that doesn't matter, as this is an internal flow and that doesn't cross the boundaries of my control volume. So both in and outflow are zero. Hence, the ddt of the mass of x total in the system, I'll give that a superscript total, is zero, or the total mass in the system is conserved. Well, I guess you knew that, but this is a systematic way of doing. Okay, I can write this at t equals zero, I have the volume of A times the concentration of x in A at zero, plus the volume of B times the concentration of B at zero. This is the total mass present, and that stays present also at the end. So at t is infinity, I get the same type of expression, B infinity. All right, this is one equation for two unknowns, but I have an additional equation. This one is at the end, the equilibrium value. So m times cb inf must equal ca at infinity, because if I wait long enough, the system will reach equilibrium. Now I have an equation for only one unknown. The volumes are the same, so I can scratch them out. I'll do that in yellow so that you can see what I'm doing. The volumes are the same, I just choose the system such. You can make any other choice. And thus I get m plus 1 times cb inf equals ca0 plus cb0, which was 3 kilogram per cube. This is 31. And thus, slide this a little bit further, thus I find ZB inf is 3 over 31 kilo per cube, and hence in A 30 times as much is 90 over 31 kilo per cube. And I've solved the second equation. All right, let me put this on totally so that you can see what I've been doing. Can I put this on page display? Entire page. This is our entire analysis. You can read that back for yourself if you want.